Have you had an issue with your air conditioner lately where the circuit breaker at the main panel keeps tripping? Have you gone over to the side of the house and tried to flip that breaker on, only to have it flip right back off? In this video, I wanted to talk to you about what could be going wrong with your AC when this happens. If this is your first time watching our channel, please click subscribe down here on the bottom right. And if you click that little bell next to it, you'll be notified of all of our videos as they come out. It's not fun to come home and realize that your house, which should be at a cool 75 degrees right now, is sitting at a balmy 85 degrees. So you go over to the side of your house and open the main electrical panel, only to find that the circuit breaker on the air conditioner has tripped. This means no high voltage power is getting to your AC to let it run. Not cool. You flip the breaker back to the on position, only to have it trip again, either immediately or after a few minutes or even seconds. Now what? So you call your local AC guy. He comes out the next day, and now that the system has been sitting idle for several hours, it doesn't surprise me when the technician who comes over for a $100 weekend service call flips the switch on the breaker and the system starts working again. Hey, someone's got the magic touch. You pay the smart technician the diagnostic fee, and they head out to their next service call. Meanwhile, after 30 minutes of the system running fine, the breaker trips again. Well, the technician is way down the road now and likely can't be back to fix it until Monday when they reopen. If the breaker trips after a certain amount of time, there's a problem with one of the parts inside the AC. If the breaker trips immediately after turning it back on, there's something going on in the wiring. You can't just flip the breaker back on and hope that it stays that way. It might, but most likely there's a reason that it tripped, and that problem will come back around. When this comes up with my technicians at Fox Family, I tell them to slow down and ask themselves, why did the breaker trip? Sure, the breaker reset when you flipped it back on, but a technician finds out why it tripped. Danger. I want to reiterate that I'm only giving homeowners and technicians some ideas here as to why the breaker is tripping. I'm not advising anyone to go out and try to fix their system on their own. Working with high voltage can cause severe injury and even death to even the most experienced technicians. I read about it all the time in the mechanical chat groups that I'm in. A breaker trips when there is too much power consumption or current at any given time. The wire from the AC to the panel heats up enough that it trips to stop a potentially hazardous situation from happening. Here are some reasons that your AC will cause the breaker to trip. Number one, the breaker could be bad. Number two, the compressor or fan is drawing too many amps. Number three, a short circuit. And number four, refrigerant pressure issues. Number one, the breaker could be bad. This doesn't happen a lot. Breakers are sturdy switches, and when heated up enough and trips repeatedly, can become weaker and trip more easily. If you use one of those infrared cameras on the market and look at the breaker, you can see the heat actually coming out of it compared to the other breakers. A new breaker can fix this problem. Two, the compressor or fan is drawing too many amps. Now, I can't cover every situation that could happen here, but I'll give you a couple ideas about what it could be. If a motor gets stuck and can't turn over when the proper voltage is applied, the motor will pull a higher number of amps. So much so that the heat builds up in the wiring and trips the breaker. This won't trip the breaker immediately, but after a while, and there really is no specified amount of time. The breaker can trip as long as the thermostat is calling for the AC to be on. This happens at the beginning of the cooling season a lot of times. That black cylinder at the bottom of your outdoor unit pumps the refrigerant back and forth through the system, like the heart does in the body. Assuming the capacitor is good, sometimes adding a hard start capacitor to the circuit will help give it that boost that's needed to turn the motor over. If it does, count your blessings and start saving up for a new compressor or AC unit altogether, because it's running on borrowed time. It's just a matter of time before your AC gives out. Number three, a short circuit. Another reason for a breaker to trip is because of an electrical short. When two normally sheathed wires, like a hot wire and a neutral wire, touch each other when voltage is applied, it can cause a major event. The air conditioner uses 240 volts though, which means the two or three wires leading to your motor carry at least 120 volts. A third one can carry even more. If two bare wires touch each other when the system is supposed to be on, a high current situation can occur, causing the breaker to trip. As soon as the voltage is applied, the breaker will trip immediately. Another way the breaker will trip immediately is if one of the motor's wires touch the inside wall of the compressor. Remember, these motors have windings inside of the system that help them spin the motor shaft. The windings are covered with sheathing to protect the wiring, but it still happens, especially on older systems that have been running for 10 to 20 years or longer. Refrigerant pressure issues. One last reason a compressor would trip the AC breaker is refrigerant pressure. If the pressure is too high in the system, meaning there's too much refrigerant, the compressor is once again having to strain too hard to do its work. The breaker won't trip immediately, but over time. This doesn't happen near as much as the other events I've explained above, but can look like a bad compressor. Removing a pound of refrigerant will tell you if it's a pressure-related issue because you'll see both sides of your gauges go down a little. If this happens and the temperature split stays between 18 and 22 degrees, I would try removing refrigerant until you get the compressor amps back down below the RLA and the temp split stays within range. If removing the refrigerant isn't working as well as you'd like, it might be smart to tell the customer you'd like to remove all of the refrigerant and start all over again with virgin refrigerant and a factory charge. You don't know this system's history, and you're not expected to, especially if the homeowner doesn't know it or have invoices showing what previous technicians have done to repair their AC in the past. It's a fair solution for both of you. If you do this and the compressor is still pulling high amps and you've checked everything else on the system, you've got a bad compressor. These are just a few reasons why the circuit breaker in your home could trip the breaker in the main electrical panel. If it trips immediately after turning it back on, you likely have a problem in the wiring. If your breaker trips after a certain amount of time, though, something's going on with a part in the AC system. I can't tell you that anybody can fix these problems by themselves. In fact, you might not even be able to order these parts you need, as it takes a licensed contractor to purchase them from a local distributor. Let a professional come out and diagnose the exact problem and then fix the system so that you can have peace of mind. And if this is your first time watching our channel, please click subscribe down here on the bottom right. And if you click that little bell next to it, you'll be notified of all of our videos as they come out. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.
You're watching Fox Family Heating and Air. Don't forget to subscribe and check out more of our videos by clicking on the right side of the screen.